Get done with it!
Scotty's Hotties. Unfortunately, he's dead. So he asked us to do it. I am the last Pringle in the can that you just can't reach because your hand is just a little too fat, Christina Vixen.
And I'm Rose from the Titanic. If she were smart and stayed with the rich man and got the diamond, Jayla Baitt.
And welcome to Scotty's Hotties yet again.
Wait, what's happening?
You said just do whatever we want.
What is going on? I'm so confused.
Why isn't it looking at us?
Oh, okay. Actually, this is What the Cover.
Hey, guys.
On MSU-TV, Channel 85.
Hey.
I'm Alyssa Thomas.
I'm Ricky Nelson, and I didn't get the memo,
right.
Apparently.
I mean, I need a dress and drag today. What about you?
I didn't know,
so
obviously.
Sorry.
I look like a hippie.
Someone took her post-it. I don't know what happened. But somehow she was just like, I didn't get the post-it, you guys.
She didn't.
And, I mean, that's okay. There always needs to be a duck.
Yeah. But today is a special episode, as you can see. We have our beautiful friends here today. Introduce your lovely selves.
Once again, I'm Christina Vixen.
And I'm Jayla Baitt.
Ooh.
With two T's.
Two T's.
Oh, if we're specifying, mine is with three X's in Vixen because, I mean, you can guess.
Why not?
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Well, this is our final episode of What the Cover. I know, it's really sad.
It took them this long to have us on.
This long.
We wanted the best for last.
Yeah,
I mean,
duh.
Obviously.
Just had the best the entire time, I'd say. Why have time for anyone else whenever you have this?
It would have been very interesting to have you guys this entire time.
Yep.
But I'm very excited that you're here today.
Me too.
We're excited to be here.
Yeah, we're gonna have so much fun.
We're coming off a lot of drag stuff. So we had our show on campus, and so you guys invited us here, and we were like, of course, we'll just stay dressed for it. So we've been like this for 2 weeks.
And my ankles are still here, and I just decided to keep going, you know?
See, what happens is Jayla always trips on stage.
She always
finds the hole, which is basically Jayla. And so she always finds the hole that her foot gets caught in, and she takes a tumble. And I'll prepare some gifts of those for everyone.
But she's
so that's
still
like
here,
your signature,
I mean,
I like
it.
It's an
my
unwanted
signature. You know, my vice is falling, but my talent is getting back up.
Hey, I love that. Okay,
it's true.
You guys chose a song
for us
to play. So what is that song?
We chose The Realness by RuPaul because we're real women.
Real
women.
Yeah.
But that song is about like the identity that you're portraying and who you are and what you want to be, and it's got this very disco feel.
Awesome.
And so it's really fun, and so we hope everyone enjoys it.
All right, let's go to that now.
Real is what you feel, feelings aren't real. Put your money down, it's your battle, spin the wheel. Real is what you feel, feelings aren't real. Put your money down, it's your battle, spin the wheel. Real is what you feel, feelings aren't real. Put your money down, it's your battle, spin the wheel. Real is what you feel, feelings aren't real. Put your money down, it's your battle, spin the wheel.
Hey, we're back.
Woo!
I love that song.
It's so good. It's off of RuPaul's album, The Realness. Mm-hmm. And season 8 of RuPaul's Drag Race, the top 3 were able to guest star in the music video.
Ooh, that's cool.
Because that's a thing that Ru does every mm-hmm. season, is the top 3 always get to do a music video from a song off her latest album. Mm-hmm. And that's where we hope to be one day.
Yeah, and season 9 is actually happening right now. They're only a couple episodes in. Ooh. So it premieres every Friday night at
8 o'clock
on VH1, so go check it out.
Now it's on like basic cable, so anyone can watch it.
Wow. Is that the show that Lady Gaga like went in as disguise?
Yes, it was the first episode.
Yes. Yeah.
The
and first everyone episode. Thought she was actually a drag queen.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Love the first that. Episode, it's called Oh My Gaga, and it's beautiful, and they have to actually do runway looks inspired by Gaga. And so, like, some of them just turned it out.
Oh, yeah.
That's amazing. Yeah, Lady Gaga is just...
She brought me back with Joanne, but she kind of lost me in the art flop era. Yeah.
I've always been here, so I don't know. What I never left.
So, like, this song is just a feel-good song.
It is. Mm-hmm. It's jam. Something that you're sitting with your hunties and kikiing, and you're getting ready to go out to the club, and you're just like, I'm feeling myself. Like, I'm giving you Posh Spice if she agreed to the Spice Girls reunion realness, and she's giving you Rose in the Titanic if she hadn't ended up on the door realness, and you're giving us Britney at her Sweet 16 realness, and Ricky is giving us Hobo Chic realness.
And it's a great song too, because you don't have to use a lot of foot movement, which is great for me, so you can just do hand stuff.
Because if Jayla tries to walk, she just ends up on the floor, which is why we're sitting this entire time.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
I'm bolted to this seat.
Somehow we've glued her down.
Oh.
Fake news.
All right, well, it's time for news.
Woo!
So, Miss Vixen, I hear you have us a little story to tell.
I do. Did you all hear that Britney is going on tour, and in Israel they've actually moved their election day because she's going on tour and they don't want it to clash? And I'm just sitting there thinking, why couldn't we have done that with our election?
Right?
Where was Britney to help us?
Come on, Britney.
Britney! Like,
we already sat
girl.
Through Britney Jean, and you can't help a girl out?
We sat through Britney Ever After because of Lifetime. And now Britney needs to come back and just help us out.
I mean, she helped out Israel, apparently.
She did. She helped out Israel, so they have time to think about it.
I wouldn't think she would be that big over there, either.
Britney's big everywhere.
She is.
That's true.
She's a global phenomenon. Mm-hmm.
By Glory on iTunes.
By Glory.
But, like, she's still going strong. Like,
she is. She's getting ready for the 20-year anniversary of Baby One More Time.
Wow.
Which I'm just like, how can you? How does she look that good?
We're all old.
We are.
I'm 72, so she's doing well.
Okay. We'll be back after this, guys.
Do you like the blues? Do you like rock and roll? Do you like country? And do you like everything in between? Because if so, you should watch my show on MSU-TV, Deep Grooves. I'll be showing any type of music that I can think of between then. It'll be fun, or at least slightly entertaining.
All right, so I'm going to ask you some questions, queen.
Questions!
How did you guys get into drag?
Well, Jayla's clumsy on her own, so she figured why not make money doing it. And I'm just a whore, so why not make it very fun anyways?
Oh my gosh, I love it. All right, Ricky, you got a question for
okay. him? Okay, can I ask him a fun question?
Yeah.
Okay.
We can ask
Fun questions. Who are the inspirations for your looks?
Well, as I said before, Rose from the Titanic, but if she was smart and kept the diamond, not thrown it off the boat at the end, still mad. But, yeah, I'm just living that fantasy tonight, giving you an alternate ending, you know?
Deleted scene.
I love it.
And what's Christina wearing tonight?
I really love Victoria Beckham, Posh Spice, and she needs to go back to the Spice Girls reunion. I get that you have your fashion line, but make that money, girl. And I'm also really inspired by, like, Elvira, the Mistress of the Dark.
I love Elvira.
She's beautiful and amazing. She was my first girl crush, and I'm, like, hella gay.
Now, is that what the cashier at Goodwill told you when they sold you this, or?
Oh!
No. See, actually, that's what the cashier at Goodwill told me about your dress, that your breasts are kind of lopsided.
Queen fight!
I survived a shipwreck, so let me live.
I survived.
Because the Atlantic didn't.
Listen, I survived Jerry Halliwell, so I think I won.
I survived the 90s.
I survived the 90s. I survived that
barely.
First.
Oh my goodness.
I survived that first Spice Girls reunion.
All right, I have a next question.
Okay.
How much money have you spent on drag attire?
Love it. A good amount.
Yeah, that's a good answer.
This is actually my real body.
How much is the United States debt right now? And multiply that by about 20.
How much is Morehead State's tuition?
That's fair enough. I mean,
nice.
I mean, it's what normal girls spend on clothes, probably. Like,
yeah, because we're
girls.
Women.
Yeah.
We're regular women.
Yeah, it's what we. Yeah, it's what we all do.
Yeah.
Okay, so you guys have another song for us. Why don't you tell us what your second song is?
So our second song is Call Me on the Ouija Board by Season 4 RuPaul's Drag Race winner, Sharon Needles.
It's from her album PG-13.
Okay, let's take a look.
It's just you and me, baby. We're trapped in two different worlds. Now I know you're no downtown boy, but I'm no uptown girl neither. We're trapped in two different realms, you see. You wanna talk to me? Well, then drop the phone and pick up the board. I'll be your Carolyn, I'll be your pentagram. Let's dabble in the black arts. This is not a game, let me spell my name. Place your fingers on the board and tell me what you'll do to me. I will spell a fantasy and cast a spell of ecstasy. A little touch of magic. Ow. In this world obsessed with science, I'll be your Carolyn, I'll be your pentagram. Let's dabble in the black arts. This is not a game, let me spell my name. Let's keep this in the dark.
You didn't bring your Ouija board here?
I left it at home with my mom. I feel like she needs to talk to some dead people a little bit more than I do.
She left it in her other purse.
It's in my other
common
bag.
Common mistake.
I left it at home. See, my mom's getting a little bit closer to that point, so she needs to find some friends.
Oh, okay.
So it's like afterlife dating. But that song, you chose that one, actually, and so you talk about it a little bit.
Actually, personally, that's my favorite song by a drag queen. I feel like it's so campy and fun, and the video is just so crazy and in your face, and there's so many references, and it's just so catchy. And yeah.
It really is.
I love it.
And Sharon does that goth humor, and it was something brand new to the show whenever she came on to RuPaul's Drag Race. No one was very dark humor-esque.
Yeah.
So her coming in and being like, I'm dead. Like, nobody'd done that, and nobody'd seen it. And so it was completely new, and she's changed the face of drag in a way like that.
Yeah.
It is so being cool. able to that bring really more cool. identities in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. It definitely works out well for us, because now that makes it more versatile for what we do.
Yeah.
So who knows? You may see me as Wednesday Addams sometime soon. Who knows?
I like it. All right, so... Do you guys have questions for us?
We do.
Yay!
Let's see here. There are questions.
We get to talk about ourselves.
We're also
going to
talk about
ourselves.
Okay. First question is, what is your favorite old Nickelodeon show?
Oh, no.
You have 2 seconds
SpongeBob.
To answer.
SpongeBob. Rugrats.
What the hell is wrong with you people? Favorite old Nickelodeon show.
But SpongeBob is old.
Mine is Angela Anaconda. The one where they had Nanana and you were like, she's out of, like...
Wait, I want to change mine to Kablam.
Old Nickelodeon show.
I can understand.
They had Nickelodeon in the Stone Age.
They did. They
had the Great Depression.
Doug. Hey, Arnold.
Jayla has a mild rash on her thighs and a slight fever. What do you believe is wrong?
I love it.
I don't know. Because of the fever?
Because of the fever or the rash?
Maybe she's born
the rash,
with it. Maybe
like
it's tuberculosis.
Drag, you know, like
yeah.
Or like,
maybe maybe some of your clothes just irritated your skin.
And, you know, and the fever. I don't know.
I agree with Jayla. I think it's tuberculosis.
Psych. It's the depression.
Oh my god.
So in 10 seconds or less, describe each other in dating profiles.
Oh no! Like I describe Ricky.
Yes.
Yes.
10 seconds or less.
Okay, I describe Alyssa. She's short but spunky. She is.
Is that it? Alyssa, go.
Okay. She's beautiful. She's flawless. She's everything I want to be. This is turning into a rap song.
Sounds like a cheer.
I don't know what to say.
Bring it on, hunty.
Hello.
I wouldn't describe Jayla on a dating profile because I'm afraid she doesn't have internet because she can't afford it.
For Christina, I would just put deceased.
That was amazing. I love this.
Living for it. These are such good questions. Oh, we're such good hosts.
Yes, you are.
Why do you guys have a show and when we don't?
Right?
Fake news.
All right, we're back with more news.
More news.
News. We're back with the news.
Okay, Mel B of the Spice Girls is currently going through a bitter divorce from her second husband.
Oh, no.
So sad.
It is. It's really sad. And she is my second favorite Spice Girl.
I
behind
just want
Posh
her to
Spice.
Find love.
Listen, I just want her to find Nemo.
So if you guys want to be her new man, go check her out now and sign into her DMs. Spice up her life.
Spice up her life. Make her feel scary.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yes. God. And then next we have Mariah Carey is about to release a new album and she's founding her own label. And I'm just really happy that hopefully her mic was working in the studio. Because it wasn't at New Year's.
No.
I'm going to just walk away on that note. Mariah Carey, man. Yep.
It's just going to be an album of silent interpretive dance.
I feel like she used to have talent, but she just somehow just lost it all.
I feel like she still has the talent. I just feel like she's
not the drive. All the motivation is gone.
She gets out there, she's like, hey.
Hey, I'm Mariah Carey.
Collect the
paycheck. That's a diva. That's a diva for you.
Yeah,
that's
true.
Janet Jackson and her husband have split after 5 years and exactly 3 months. But she signed a prenuptial agreement which states that if she stayed for at least 5 years, she's guaranteed $500 million.
That's a businesswoman.
She
I just have to applaud this woman.
Smart.
Like, hey. Yep.
She got the money. She got a child.
That's dedication.
That
yeah,
is
let's
she,
just point
and
that
she got out.
It's dedication.
I've been in a relationship on and off for 5 years, and sometimes you just got to take that break, and she's taking that break on vacation with that money somewhere else.
Yep. And I just like money, so I do it. Yep.
I'm here for the money. I'm here for the green, which obviously isn't evidenced because we're extremely poor. So if you want to send us money, ask for our PayPals. Hi, I'm about to intro song three, and guess what that is? It's something that I chose. It's called Take Me There by Adore Delano, and it's off her second album, After Party. So catch us after the song, and we'll talk about it more. It's a really good song. She was really successful with her first album, Till Death Do Us Party. And so with After Party, she came out and she released this song. And it's just about having a good time.
Yeah.
It's about kikiing with your friends and hanging out and making sweet music.
Just fun stuff. I like it.
Yeah,
I
just like it a lot of fun.
And if you ever get the chance to see her live, she is amazing.
She was the first Rue girl I've ever seen live.
Oh, wow.
Like, performing, and she is so charismatic. There's a reason she is a fan favorite, because she will spend so much time talking with the fans. She will spend so much time. Mm-hmm. You wore a pug shirt, I think it was.
Yeah.
And she was like, I love your
we
pug shirt.
We bonded over pugs. It was amazing.
Wow.
That's
it
awesome.
Was
that
beautiful.
Is awesome.
See, I love when they connect with their fans.
Mm-hmm. They do.
Yeah,
they're
it's the best.
Yeah. They're amazing.
Their
and
fans
she's,
are why they're there.
She performed live, and it was beautiful and amazing, and I want to see her again.
So, I just got assigned a drag name.
Yeah.
She's giving us, like, first episode Hannah Montana realness.
Mm-hmm.
So we're calling her Hunty Montana.
Hunty Montana.
Hunty Montana.
Yes.
And Ricky doesn't get a drag name because she didn't get the post-it.
I didn't get the post-it.
But Tim did.
Yeah, Tim got the post-it.
Yeah.
Tim got a lot of post-its.
Someone put Hi Tim on his dorm post-its today. And if you don't know who Tim is, he is our professor over this practicum.
Yep.
Yeah.
I checked out a camera from him once.
Good old Tim.
How sweet.
Good old Tim.
Timbo Slice.
The home dog. Well, this is our last episode of What the Cover. And I'm so glad that we got you queens
so
on here.
So glad.
I'm so glad you guys were able to be guests on our show.
Me too.
Me too.
Yeah.
Like, I'm so glad you could be here for this.
Yeah.
I am too.
Like this is beautiful and
I'm
amazing.
I'm so glad that you gave us the honor of being here with you.
I
Absolutely.
Too.
You're always welcome here at Katie Couric with Katie Couric.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, it definitely works out. Catch us next on the O Network.
Hey.
Well, you have been watching MSU-TV, Channel 85. I'm Alyssa Thomas. Actually, no.
No.
No. I'm Hunty Montana.
She's Hunty Montana. I'm Ricky Nelson.
I'm Christina Vixen. Follow me on Twitter at MadamXXXV.
I'm Jayla Baitt. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Jayla Baitt.
With two T's.
Two T's.
Two T's. And Mr. Skull, as always.
Yeah, Mr. Skull says
Mr.
bye.
Skull.
He told you. He's going to miss
Mr.
you the
Skull.
Most.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah,
he is.
He's been with us this whole time. So.
This whole time.
Well, this is our sign-off.
This is our sign-off.
Bye,
for
guys.
What the Cover. Bye.
Say bye, queens.
Bye, queens.
Bye, queens.
Bye.
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 Bye,
buddy. I hope
Peace.
You find your dad.
No. What are you doing? Are we going to ask you questions?
I mean, it's just stuff that we can ask each other. If you were stranded on a deserted island with Donald Trump, Paul Ryan, and Ted Cruz, who would you kill for food?
Myself. So if we go straight into the Q&A, it's like,
hello?
Oh, dear Lord.
I thought you were
shaking,
a serial killer.
I did, too.
I was
calling about
Ouija
board.
I was like, I can't die looking like this.
We got all the
My mom would be so disappointed.
Like,
I was a Boy Scout. That's their motto, is be prepared. You'd never guess I was a Boy Scout.
That was their motto, be prepared.
But I didn't care.
I promise to do my best and do my duty to God and my country.
You got another question for him?
No.
Okay.
Well, all right.